Good morning, friends. Myself, Mr. M.D. Joshi. I am going to start the next point from the topic mathematical methods. Friends, in last grade we have seen about what is meaning of scalar, vector, and we have also seen the distinguishing point regarding the scalars and vectors. And again, I have given you some homework regarding with how to find the magnitude. I hope all of you have solved that. Today we are going to see the next point of the topic, that is the types of vector. There are different types of vectors. First, equal vectors. Opposite vector, null vector, resultant vector, position vector, and unit vector. These are the six types of vector which are included in your syllabus. Again, I am going to explain about the types of vector: equal vector, opposite vector, null vector, resultant vector, position vector, and unit vector. These are the total six types of vector. So today we are going to take the information about these vectors. First, we'll see about the equal vectors. So, what is meaning of equal vectors? So, here we have to compare one vector with another. Let us consider this is a vector P and this is the vector Q. So if the vector P has a magnitude of 5 meter and Q has a magnitude of 5 meter, and if both vectors are moving in the same direction, then what we can say that these are two equal vectors. So what is the definition of equal vectors? The two vectors having the same magnitude and same direction are known as equal vectors. Remember, not necessary that they should be one ahead another, they may be this way also, parallel manner, 5 meter and vector Q 5 meter. So here also you can observe the direction is the same. What is the equal vectors? Two vectors having the same magnitude and same direction are known as equal vectors. Now, opposite vector. The word itself indicate about the direction. So what is meaning of opposite vector? Two vectors of same physical quantity. This word is very important. Suppose if first is a force and then other quantity should be also force, then we can compare. If one is a force and other is a displacement, then we cannot compare them. So in order to do the comparison, there should be the same physical quantity. Okay, so the two vectors of the same physical quantity, suppose vector P 5 meter, vector Q 5 meter. Okay, so Newton is the unit of the force. So what we can say, two vectors of the same physical quantity having the same magnitude but opposite in direction is known as opposite vector. What is the meaning of opposite vector? Two vectors of same physical quantity having the same magnitude but opposite direction is known as opposite vector. Next, third is a null vector. Null vector is also known as a zero vector. So why it is known as zero vector? because its magnitude is zero. So how we can define the null vector or zero vector? The vector whose magnitude is zero. The vector whose magnitude is zero is known as a null vector. So if we want to explain this with one example, then we can take one common example. Velocity is equals to displacement upon time. This is a formula for velocity. Okay. Now, if the observer is stationary, S-T-A-T-I-O-N-A-R-Y, stationary means at the rest position. If the particle is at the rest position, means displacement is zero, and zero divided by time is a zero. So that we can say the example of the null vector. Means the particle at the stationary position have its velocity as zero. This is the example of null vector. So again, I am explaining the null vector. Null vector is also known as a zero vector. The vector whose magnitude is zero is known as a null vector or zero vector. Its example is the object which is at the stationary position have its velocity as a null vector. So why it is a null vector? Because velocity has the formula displacement upon time, and when the object is stationary, it is not moving, so its displacement is zero, as a result velocity is zero. So it is the example of null vector. Okay. Next is a resultant vector. Resultant vector. So resultant vector is a single vector which will represent the effect of given vectors. For example, suppose this is a vector having the magnitude of 1 meter. Suppose this is another vector Q having the magnitude of 5 meter. If we add them, we are getting a vector, suppose a vector S having the effect as a 6 meter, 1 plus 5, 6, right? So what we can say, vector S is a resultant vector because this single vector will represent the effect of two vector. So what is a resultant vector? Resultant vector is a single vector which will represent the effect of given two vectors. So this is about the resultant vector. Okay, again I am going to explain these four vectors once again. Equal vectors, two vectors having the same magnitude and same direction is known as equal vectors. Opposite vector, two vectors of the same physical quantity but opposite, having the same magnitude but opposite in direction, is known as opposite vector. Null vector, the vector whose magnitude is zero is known as a null vector or zero vector. Next, resultant vector. The resultant vector is a single vector which will represent the effect of given two vectors. Next vector we are going to see is a position vector. Position vector. This is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, this is the point P having the coordinates x, y. Okay. It can be represented by the vector r. So vector r will indicate the position of point P with respect to the coordinate system. Here O, 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 that is a 0 and 0, this is the coordinates. So we can consider this point as O having the coordinates 0, 0. So what is a position vector? Position vector is a vector which represents the position of particle with respect to the given coordinate system. So here the vector r is known as a position vector. So again, I am going to explain the definition of the position vector. What is a position vector? The position vector is a vector which represents the position of a particle with respect to the given coordinate system. So it will indicate where the particle is exactly present. Next is a unit vector. So what is the meaning of unit vector? The vector having the unit magnitude is known as unit vector. For example, we can consider this is a vector m, right? Then we can multiply with the u cap, that it indicates its direction, and this m, that is also magnitude. So u cap is also unit vector is equals to given vector divided by its magnitude. Okay, so this is the formula to find the unit vector. So how to define the unit vector? The vector whose magnitude is unit is known as unit vector. Vector m is equals to unit vector or u cap multiplied by magnitude of m. So u cap is equals to vector m divided by its magnitude. Now I am going to explain this with one example. Example: vector p is equal to 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap. Find the unit vector of p. Now we have to find the unit vector of vector p. Now how to solve this? I am writing its solution. We should use the formula u cap is equal to vector p divided by the magnitude of vector p. So here unit vector, what is vector p? 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap upon its magnitude. So in last grade we have seen how to calculate the magnitude. So take the given vectors coefficients in terms of the square root. So under 3 square plus 2 square plus 5 square. So u cap is equal to 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap. Now here, what is the square of 3? 9. Square of 4? Square of 2? 4. Square of 5? 25. So if we add them, 25 plus 4, 29, 30, and then 30. So if you add this, 3 square 9 plus 4, 11. So 25 plus 11, you can get the answer as a here 25 plus 30, you are getting the answer as a 38, right? So you can write here u cap is equals to 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap upon root 38. So this is a unit vector of given vector p. Friends, again I am going to explain this example. So what is the question? Vector given is a vector p is equal to 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 cap. Find the unit vector of p. So unit vector's formula u cap is equal to given vector divided by magnitude. What is the given vector? 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap upon its magnitude. And when we are dividing the magnitude, remember 3 square 9, 2 square 4, 5 square 25. So 9 plus 4, 13. So if we are adding, we are getting the root 38. So if we are getting the factors, then you can simplify, or otherwise you can keep as it is. Further, someone can also write it as a u cap is equals to 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 5t cap, and divide each term with root 38, root 38, and root 38. That is also the answer regarding the unit vector. So again, I am going to explain this part. What is a unit vector? Unit vector is a vector which have the magnitude as a unit. But the vector whose magnitude is unit is known as a unit vector. Basically, the unit vector will indicate the direction. So we are using the symbol as a cap. So what is the formula for the unit vector? U cap is equal to unit vector divided by its magnitude. So here, u cap is equal to vector m divided by its magnitude of m. Now for example, vector p have the magnitude 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 5i cap. Find the unit vector of p. Then we should use a formula, substitute the value, and after that, we got the final answer 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 5i cap upon under root 38, and then you can write it separately. And the example is not given in your textbook, but only the formula is given. This example I am going to explain regarding with the formula. So in the numericals, the questions are asked. Okay, so I hope today you have understood the part regarding the type of vector. Now take one question for homework. Example, vector p is equals to 2i cap plus 3j cap minus k cap. This is the question for homework. Vector p is equals to 2i cap plus 3j cap minus k cap. Find the unit vector of p. Okay, try to solve at home in the same manner. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.